my geekiness is getting in the way of my nerdiness, I'm starting to notice as I grow older. I had this really sad realization. I was thinking the other day about a time machine, if I had a time machine, you know, because I'm really into history, like would I go back and witness something, or like find out who Jack the Ripper was, or stop the Kennedy assassination? And the first thing I thought of doing, if I actually had a time machine, is I would go back to around 1993 or 94 and kill George Lucas with a shovel. That was the first thing that came to my mind. And stop him from making the prequels. That's how I would try to save history. Fucking pathetic. I mean, I don't even know how I would have reacted if I had just run into him on the street, like going, "Oh my God, you're fucking George Lucas, dude. Look, I don't want to bother you and nerd out, but like, Star Wars is one of my favorite movies, and I just want to thank you, man. Just thanks for all that. It's so great. Ah, you like Star Wars? I got some good news. I'm working on the three prequels, the first three chapters. Oh, really? You're gonna do the, finally, oh my God, that's awesome, dude, I'm so excited, I can't wait. Well, hey, you say you're a Star Wars fan, do you like Darth Vader? I fucking love Darth Vader, dude, the helmet and the cape with the sword, that's great, man. Is he in the first movie? Yeah, in the first movie, you get to see him as a little kid. Is he like a little Damien Omen kid, like evil and killing people with his mind and shit like that? No, he's just like this little kid, and then he gets taken away from his mom and he's very sad. I don't really care about him as a little kid at all. I just like the helmet and the sword and the cape. That was kind of cool about him. Well, hey, don't worry, because guess who shows up in the second movie? Boba Fett. There you fucking Boba Fett, yes! With the helmet and he's a bounty hunter. That is awesome, man. That is so cool. Yeah, and in the second movie, you get to see him as a little kid. Again, I don't really care about him when he was a little kid. I like the ship and the helmet and the killing people. Is he like it? Does he have the little helmet on and he's killing people? Is that what's going on? No, he's like this little kid and then his dad dies and he's very sad. Do not give a shit at all about that. Could not care less. Well, don't worry, because in the third movie, you know what shows up? The Death Star. Awesome, man, that fucking... Wait a minute, what is it doing, George? Well, you just see it at the very end of the movie. It's being built, and Darth Vader's just kind of looking at it. Again, I don't care how they built it, how they put in the toilets or the air conditioning. I just like it when it's done, and then it's blowing planets up. That's kind of what's cool about it.
You look really sad.
Dude, I gotta say, I'm pretty fucking sad, man. That sounds awful. That all just sounds like shit.
Would you like some ice cream?
I would like some ice cream. I like ice cream, man. That'd be cool if I had like a dish of ice cream.
Well, here's a big bag of rock salt.
You just said I was gonna have a dish of ice cream.
Well, when you combine the rock salt with ice and cream and sugar and flavoring, it becomes,
I don't give a shit where the stuff I love comes from. I just love the stuff I love. Hey, do you like Angelina Jolie? Does she give you a big boner? Well, here's John Voight's ball sack. That's right. The pink, glistening ball sack she swam out of. Now jerk off to that, you lucky so-and-so.